So what's going on, guys? It's JM, it's V Boxing. Make sure you guys subscribe to this channel before you click on to any of the videos. Also comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions on what I'm saying in any of the videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So I've just seen something interesting on my Twitter feed about a possible fight that could be made in January 2018 to kick off the year. And that's a fight between WBC light heavyweight champion Adonis Stevenson and former light heavyweight and super middleweight champion Badou Jack. And I've just checked BoxRec and Adonis Stevenson is penciled in to fight on the 27th of January at the Videotron Center in Quebec City. Will Badou Jack be the man he's facing that night? And what's interesting about this as well is that, is Adonis Stevenson ever going to fucking face his mandatory challenger? Because Eladio Alvarez has been mandatory for about 2 years. Just over 2 years, nearly. So, will he ever get to face Adonis Stevenson? Like, this guy won a fight against Isaac Chalemba to pick up the WBC silver title. He was made mandatory not long after that. And then he fought two other guys, just like 10-round tune-up fights. And then he fought Lucien Boutte. And then he fought Jean Pascal. So he's had three title eliminators. And two tune-up fights, and he still hasn't had a crack at Adonis Stevenson's title. So, yeah, Adonis Stevenson has definitely made Eladio Alvarez jump through hoops. But I like the Badou Jack fight. I do like that fight because I think if anyone is going to beat Adonis Stevenson, it's somebody like a Badou Jack now, because Adonis Stevenson has definitely slowed down in the past couple of years. Like, he's been very inactive. He's had about two fights in almost 2 years. And he's what, 40 years old? Is he 40 years old now? Yeah, he's 40 years old, Adonis Stevenson. And he has definitely slowed down. He does get hit a bit more than what he used to. He doesn't look as sharp as he did when he fought Tony Bellew and Tavoris Cloud, and when he knocked Chad Dawson out to win the title and stuff like that. And in his last fight, he fought Fonfara back in June and he blasted him out in a couple of rounds. But in my opinion, Fonfara is pretty much a shot fighter. He was coming off a devastating loss to Joe Smith Jr. and he had that fight with Chad Dawson in which he was losing until he managed to hurt and stop Chad Dawson in the 10th round. So yeah, that performance was what it was. And plus, he'd already fought Fonfara before Adonis Stevenson, so he knew what he was getting himself into in there. But in terms of what Adonis Stevenson does, you know what Adonis Stevenson does. He just looks to knock you out with that big left hand. Like, that left hand is his main weapon. A lot of people say he's a one-handed fighter. He can do some things with the right hand, but predominantly he looks to take you out and hurt you with that big right hand. And that's what he uses to control fights. He has like a pouring jab, Adonis Stevenson, and stuff like that. He just looks to load up with that big right hand, and not big right hand, that big left hand. And that left hand has got some serious power to it. Like, that left hand will probably knock most guys out in the light heavyweight division. Like, if he lands clean with it, like, you're in trouble. Like, many fighters have tasted that left hand, and many fighters haven't got up from it. And Badou Jack has been knocked out in one round before by Derek Edwards, who is a journeyman. He was caught cold in a fight, Badou Jack, and was totally taken out. But since then, Badou Jack has got to be one of the most improved fighters in boxing. Like, when he won the title against Anthony Durrell, he won it by a majority decision. At the time, that was seen as a bit of an upset. But then he fought George Groves and beat him on a split decision, and then fought Boutte. That fight was a draw, even though I felt that Jack won that fight. And then he fought James DeGale, had another draw. So, oh, and then he fought Nathan Cleverley when he moved up to light heavyweight. That was his debut fight at light heavyweight. In his last fight, he picked up the WBA light heavyweight title. So ever since that knockout loss, this guy's became a two-weight world champion. So he's definitely one of the most improved fighters, Badou Jack. And he's got a very basic style, but it's very effective, Badou Jack. Like, the jab's good. The work output's good. The defense is so basic, but it works. Like, you know what I mean? Badou Jack gets in there, and when you look at him, you think he's not really doing much. You know what I mean? He's not really a technically gifted fighter. He's not really doing anything amazing in there. But what fighters seem to notice when they get in there with him is a lot harder than what they thought. Like James DeGale, for example, felt that he was a class above Badouchak because he felt like he was a technically better fighter, he could do more things in there and stuff like that. But when he got in the ring, he realized how hard the fight was, and he was dropped late in that fight, and that's what cost him the fight, because if he would have stayed on his feet, he probably would have just nicked the fight on the judges' scorecard, even though a lot of people did feel like Badouchak won the fight. But on the scorecards, if he would have stayed on his feet, he would have won the fight. So yeah, very interesting. And in his last fight, I know he just totally dispatched Nathan Cleverley, who was a good world champion, who is a decent fighter. Nathan Cleverley, two-time light heavyweight champion, been in there with some quality opposition over the years. And no one's ever dispatched of Nathan Cleverley like that before, apart from Sergei Kovalev. Like, Fon Farah couldn't do it, Tony Bellew couldn't do it. So yeah, I like that fight. And I think Badouchak has a style, really, to make it rough and tough in there with Adonis Stevenson. It'd be interesting to see if Adonis Stevenson can penetrate the defence of Badouchak with that left hand, because that defence is tight and he doesn't give a lot away, Badouchak. He's very cautious, not cautious, but he knows what he's doing with that defence. He knows how not to get hit, Badouchak, when you don't want to. Like, James DeGale was finding it very hard to get through, you know what I mean? Like, Badouchak is a fighter, in my opinion, who comes on stronger as the fight goes on. Like, for the first couple of rounds against DeGale, it looked like it could be an easy night work for DeGale, because he dropped Badouchak in the first round and he won the first few rounds. But then as the fight progressed, Badouchak started to make it hard for James DeGale and just made him work and made him tired and slowly broke him down. And could he do the same to Adonis Stevenson? Because like I said, Adonis Stevenson is 40 years old and the clock's ticking. Like, fucking Father Time's undefeated, like, that's what everyone says. So at 40 years old, can Adonis Stevenson go the rounds with Badouchak, or will he go in there and try to knock Badouchak out early, try to catch him cold? Because if not, then I'm favouring Badouchak. Like, I think the later that fight goes, you got to favour Badouchak. But early on, Adonis Stevenson's very dangerous with that left hand. That left hand is just so dangerous, and it could just take you out at any time. Like, ask Chad Dawson. Like, first round, fucking what, a minute into the fight, he was knocked out, done. And Tony Bellew, no one's ever beat Tony Bellew the way that Adonis Stevenson did it. And he's just so long. Adonis Stevenson, 77 inch reach, then big long arms. Like, it's a big, big advantage he has over other fighters. And he's not really even that tall as well, Adonis Stevenson. He's, what, 5'10"? So, yeah, it's a big advantage he does have over other fighters, but anyway, I'm waffling on now. I just think that's a really good fight. But fuck knows what's going to happen if it gets made. Maybe Adonis Stevenson does fight his mandatory challenger, Elider Alvarez, who is a good fighter, by the way. Very, very good boxer in there, Elider Alvarez. And he could cause Adonis Stevenson some problems. But I think Badouchak is slightly more of a threat to Adonis Stevenson. But Elider Alvarez is a good fighter as well. He's a decent boxer. So, yeah, comment below in the comment section. It's JM, it's Speedboxing.